first time I ever set eyes on you, it was love at first sight. You were so young, your mom told me that she had a son, and you were the love of her life. As time went on, me and you bonded, I fathered you, I was so proud to be your dad. We were so broke, I promised you that one day I would get rid of the problems we had. I hope you accept my apology, all the fights and the drunk nights that you saw in the past. You never chose sides, we were so sad, but when it came to happiness, you all we really had. You an angel, angel. So happy go lucky, such a good soul, words can't express. You had a gift in making people fall in love with you. You affected every single person you met, and we ain't had much. We spoiled you to death. Anything you wanted, you could have. I still laugh, think about the holiday when you snuck and ate a whole cheesecake. We ain't even get mad at your favorite. We were so stressed out, we were about to lose a house that we stayed in. I was trying to be a rap, but we couldn't move. Then my parents' basement, but couldn't bring you. Really, you're the one that made me quit trying to rap, so I went and got a job so that we could get a house. I'd do anything for you. You, me, and your mom moved with your grandma. It was us three stuck in a little room. Finally had a place to play outside. I would love to see you run like a dream coming true. Coming true. I was riding in my car to some tracks one day. Played this beat, started thinking of you, but now I'm
in my rearview.
I would lay in bed with you for hours on end. Me and your mom were obsessed with you, cause you were mama's baby's boy and daddy's best friend. But daddy ain't been home a lot lately to play with. I try to sit you down and explain that I got a new job that I wanted all my life, and that everything might possibly change. That I'ma have to go out of town for some months, but when I'm home, I'ma be around every day. But when I'm gone, I'ma need you to look out for your mom, keep her company when daddy's away. Your mama sent pics of you and her in bed. I would feel bad thinking that you thought I left, but now I'm saving bread so we can finally have our own place, live a life that we should have always had. And I did that. You got spoiled even more, cause instead of being crammed, now you got your own room. Your mom quit a job, now you and her can chill every day. For the most part, I be home too, and life is looking bright, used to seem so blue. We finally were content, had a daily routine. I made a bunch of songs with your name in name. I would come into your room hugging you and I would sing. You were always treated like a king, cause you were everything that mattered to us. And I would hate to see your cute face crying, cause you knew that I was leaving for a tour. Always hated when I go and grab that red suitcase out the closet. Look at me and say you promise you stay by your mom when I'm gone. I'll be back in a couple of months. Give me kisses, I'll be missing you a ton. Homesick every time I'm
looking in my rearview. Wishing I was near you. It's quiet here without you. And I've been thinking about you. Feeling a nostalgia.
You grew up so fast, but you always had a baby face, so it's hard for me to tell. You were sick on and off, we were just roughhousing on the bed. Good to see you getting well. I had to go to Omaha for a show, but your mom coming up and told me that you slipped and fell. You were limp and we figured that you twisted something and had to give it time to tell. I got home and you were breathing funny and your head was big as hell. Mama said that she began to see a swell. This morning this isn't normal. We took him to the doctor, we thought he might have broke his hip bone and it would heal. It's crazy how life changed in an instant. The doctor walked in with his x-rays, said he thought he broke his hip, but he didn't. He got bad news and there ain't no way to fix it. What is it? He said the x-ray showed bone cancer was spreading through his legs in a crazy position. The amputation, the chemo, and the option. He probably ain't gonna make it to Christmas. I blacked out, cause Christmas is like 3 weeks away. When I left, he was okay. Now you telling me he's gonna die? He said he's strong, so he's gonna fight. Eventually, you're gonna have to put him down whenever y'all decide. Please, God, not a dog, weren't shocked, not a son. He's the only thing we got. We were stunned. It'd be different if we knew that he was suffering for months. But he's living. How the fuck is that? Nothing can be done. Try to comfort him as much as we could. Drug his mattress down the stairs to the center of the living room. Me and his mom laid with him every night, petting him when he was crying. You could tell the pain was getting to him. And me and her in disbelief. All we did was cry, all we did was scream. Struggling to try to take him outside, but he could barely walk. And every day it seems it's spreading even more. The medicine we fed him is a dawn. Anything, and we just can't accept it, that a boy. The most important thing is dying right in front of us. Like how much do we let him suffer till we go and make the choice? We've been laying on the floor almost 20 days. He ain't eating anymore, he can't move his legs. It's December 21st, I think it's time for us to let him go so we can send him to a better place. It's been several weeks, making your mom still grieving, feeling like we're in denial. I go in your bedroom every day, smell the air, start to cry for a while, then I smile, think about y'all.